Well, what an interesting week it has been. I had to bite the bullet and replace my car this week. I've also had an exam today, which I passed by the devil's grace. Well, I had three tests. One was a practical test. I passed that no problem. Passed a paper about unvented hot water systems. But then there was the big paper that I'd been dreading. That's got like all the questions in it. Like there was a question in it. It's for unvented hot water, and there was questions in it about, you know, commissioning an oil-fired boiler and stuff like that. Real nasty, you know, irrelevant questions that are not relevant to the fucking course, but you've got to answer them anyway. And the pass mark was 80%, and I got just that 80%. So we're a bit pushed for time. So this is just sort of a little sit down and a chat, really, while I clean this knife, this beautiful instrument I had to use the other day for opening some cement bags. And I was mixing up concrete in my boss's garage, and it's just kind of got it, really, all that muck in there. So I'll have a little chat while we sort this out. I'm gonna clean this. We might have to strip it down. That's what these are for. And then we're gonna oil it, sharpen it, well, put it back together and sharpen it. And all the other such stuff. I've got another brush somewhere with longer bristles, but I cannot fucking find. Ooh, that was a horrible sound. Oh, God. So yeah, I've had a lot going on this week. I haven't had time even to reinstall the microwave. I had a look at it. And what I've got to do is I've got to get a long cord and pull it through, because it plugs in one of these, you know, like the microwave's in the kitchen units, yeah, you saw, and then the plug for it is somewhere else entirely, and you've got to thread it through and do all sorts of fuckery. That isn't coming up too bad. That's locking open properly now. In fact, I don't think we're going to have to take this apart. I mean, all the cement dust is just brushing straight off with a stiff brush. I'd love it if I had my big... I have a big brush, you see. And I cannot, for the life of me... Oh, shit. Oh, I cannot, for the life of me, bloody find the thing. This is a shame, because it would have been absolutely perfect for what we're doing. And it's not here, nor there, nor anywhere. Unless it's up here somewhere. It's just my life at the minute, you know. Yeah, I spent all day Saturday shopping for a car. That's an ordeal. I wouldn't wish on anybody. I had a fit of pique, even with my favourite game, XCOM. I've had to reinstall that because I deleted it. You know, rage quit, PC Gamer Edition, where you just delete the thing. You're like, oh, sod it. I'll fucking do something productive with my time. I'll write the next great novel. I'm not playing that again. Fucking game. And then, you know, you miss it. Oh, I cannot find that brush anywhere. It's going to piss me off now. Oh well, we'll just carry on with what we have as usual. As always, carrying on with what we have. Actually, that could be thrown away now. It's just a fucking thing I was looking at for cars and stuff. Yeah, all nice and clean apart from here. But you just stick the brush on it straight away, and it just comes right off because it's sort of coated with this sort of, almost has like a sort of Teflon finish for it to it. It's not Teflon, I know, but I don't know what different coatings are, you see. I mean, this is anodized. This black here. But I don't know what any of the other coatings are. Shame, really. I should find out. Shit, that torch is still on. This is a nice knife. Obviously, living in a totalitarian shithole like I do, you know, this is a highly illicit thing to have on you, but, you know, if you've got to do the job, you've got to cut something, you need a fucking knife. There's no way around it. I mean, what am I going to use to cut round, you know, the bath silicone? Silicon with the flat of my hand. Shall I stick my finger in there, cut it away with that? No. But, you know, I've never tried explaining it to a police officer, but I imagine they won't understand. At the same time, you know, what do? Do you get trodden on? Or do you, you know, get out the way? That's the deal. Right, that locks up good and well, but there's still grit and shit in there. Which is why, again, I need my longer brush. And then we're going to oil this and sharpen it where it's been fucked about with. And it hasn't been sharpened for an age. And I tell you, if you've got a cut carpet, this is your man. This thing goes through it like a razor. Forget a Stanley knife. I mean, they're shit. Once you taste a real blade, you never go back to a horrible box cutting thing. Bloody useless they are. You know, sometimes you just need something with some reach. Especially with these teeth here, you can strip wire, cut away plasterboard, functions a little bit like a pad saw. So useful. It's the most useful tool in the world. A good knife. A good sturdy knife. Now where the hell is my long brush? I will not tolerate this any longer. Let's get under here proper. There are my zip ties. You can see I'm a model of organisation. There's... Ah! It's in here. Why did I not think to check inside the pack of brushes I got? Ah! This is a tool station brush pack, and it's very good, but we want this one because it's got nice long bristles. And we've got a little handle for it in here. You can buy these as part, they're called boiler service brushing brushes. We have similar ones at my job proper, my work proper, where I work. And you know, you could get extensions, you could make this like a meter long and, you know, twirl it around and do a circus routine with it, or you can just use it. And what I want is the bristles to get right in there and do what they've got to do, you know? And the nice long handle means I don't, you know, cut my hand off either. And the next step, I suppose, is the compressor, and then the next step is taking it apart. But you know what it's like when you take something apart, you can never get it back together. That's okay, that'll work, that locks up properly, no movement in it. I mean, this is perfection, this. Absolutely no wiggle or movement. It feels really solid. You know, so you can really, when you're cutting away, you can really give it the beans, both hands, and shove and, you know, twist and all that. You can pry, use this to pry things away. Really good bit of steel on this knife. Wish I knew what it was. It's not a branded knife. It's not like a Kershaw or anything. It just says Toolcraft on it. And it came with some power tools, or so it said. This was given to me, like a lot of my things. It's given to me, and I, you know, only get to hear of where these things come from. I mean, I don't know where you'd begin to buy this, especially in this country. Knives are illegal. You have to cut everything with fucking spoons. So, there you go. That's it. Look at that. It's even got a little string cutter on there, so you don't have to unfold this and scare everybody. And, you know, that's another reason I like it. You just whip this out. It looks fairly innocuous, and you just go, oh, and people think it's like a string cutter. That's what it is. And then, you know, this comes out, and it's like, oh my god, everybody, flee for your lives. That's good now. I can't even feel the grit in there. That's come in handy, that little brush. That $5.99. Well worth it. Now, you know, you could go crazy with the oils that you use. You could, you know, use scented oils. You can use all sorts of different oils, you know, if you're into that sort of thing. But me, I'm a 3-in-1 man. My dad's a 3-in-1 man, you know, we're all 3-in-1 men here, and that's what we use. Yeah, let's put all the brushes in here, and then when I see there are no brushes, I might actually look in this kit again. Because, you know, I've got all the spare holders here. Well, actually, I haven't. These are all full. It's just the steel ones. You see, the steel brushes, cleaning off rust, those are the ones you'll wear out first. Let's put that in there. Let's put this one, let's just put it loose in there. It's not going to go anywhere. You know, if you were lugging this thing about every day for some reason, you might want to think this out a bit more, but for sitting in the toolbox, it's fine. Let's get some oil now. Yeah, you know, you could go crazy about your different oils that you use for your knives. But me, a bit of 3-in-1, and I'm happy. That is, if I got some 3-in-1, you can, there are others as well. There's a spray-on oil that I use, a German one that's quite good. Where is it? Yeah, here we go, Das Ballistol. That's what it's about right there. If you want some serious rust protection, that's fine. But that knife doesn't really rust. It's more for, you know, to help it work, not to help it fucking not rust. Although it is partly that. What have we got here? Muck off dry lube with PTFE race quality lubricant. Oh, this is for my bicycle. Back when I had, you know, in those halcyon days when I had time to ride my bike at the weekends and make YouTube videos and all the other stuff that I dreamed of doing. Oh! Whereas now all I do is prepare for the next working week by getting all my equipment and stuff ready. Like I am now. Let's put some of this in there. This isn't what I really what I want, but it'll do. It'll get us by. We might sharpen this. I might show you that on the stone in the garage. And what I want to do is I want to apply just a few drops to the lock mechanism to help keep it moving. You don't want to coat. You don't want to bath it in oil. In fact, those drops are probably too much for what I want. But you want a bit in there, just because otherwise, you know, metal rubbing on metal, it wears it away faster, it loosens up. You know, that's the deal. You've got to give it some help, especially with the gravel in there. But you don't want too much oil, because then all the dirt will stick in there, and then it really will be horrific. But that glides open and shut very nice. It's even got a little detent just there. I think that's where the ball bearing locks in. Very good. And yeah, this is a bit, this might be better actually, because 3-in-1, I used to use 3-in-1 on my bicycle, and it used to dry out in the summer heat. And I know it's the middle of fucking winter, but this knife, very often, shocker, is in my pocket. And it is often warm, so 3-in-1, we'll probably do the same, so this might actually be the better solution. Yeah, and it's biodegradable. So, yeah, lovely. Don't know what it is. Doesn't even say, doesn't give you like a chemical formula or anything. I mean, I wouldn't expect a full, you know, skeletal diagram or molecular diagram or anything, but just, you know, contains such and such. Clean will not attract contaminants. Oh, it doesn't attract contaminants, or so it says. I bet it fucking does. Ensures smooth and quiet shifting, which is important for this knife, you know. Creates a durable and protective layer. Exceptional low surface friction. Yeah, it's ideal for chains, cables, shifters, and derailleurs. Oh, whatever the fuck that says. I'm sorry, I'm a bit stupid. I can't read. you know, save the trees, all that. I've only had this sitting in my trunk for about 6 years. And I could have used this. Das Ballistol. This is a really interesting oil. This is as old as the hills. Can't really buy it in this country, you have to get it off of Amazon and it's a bloody fortune, but this is the good stuff. It's not changed formula in like 100 years. It's made in Germany, of course. You know, it's alien kraut technology. You know, with good reason. I mean, from like 1908, I think the German army used this to lubricate and preserve all their firearms. I think they still do. I don't know if they stopped using it. And it's just used everywhere. It's just sort of like their equivalent of WD-40. If WD-40 was, you know, a good lubricant, that's basically what it is. You know how WD-40, everyone's like, oh, it's great. And, you know, then they spray it in there and they think it's going to lube up everything. Yeah, it does that, but that's not really what it is. WD, I've got some here, that actually stands for water dispersant. That's what it does. It gets rid of the water. That's why it's good for rust and keeping, you know, de-rusting. You'd use this to, I use this to clean, but I wouldn't use this as a permanent lubricant because it's just going to dry out. You know, even in the can, it fucking dries out. It just goes bad. You know, it's just, it's okay, but this is better. This does not dry out. This is what I use on my backhoe adjustable spanners to keep them from rusting up when they get absolutely immersed in water. It just sort of gets in and permeates everywhere, a lot like the WD does. And you can use this for cleaning. But unlike WD-40, it doesn't just evaporate away. It doesn't just, you know, go back to the spirit in the sky. It doesn't disappear into the ether. It actually stays and lingers, and you can feel an object, you can smell it, you can taste it, you know, if you tried. Ah, XCOM's done. Let's play it. But, you know, it lingers, and that's why it's better. So, yeah, I'll take you downstairs and we'll sharpen this. I think there's some 3-in-1 in the garage. And then I think I'll say adios. Yeah, rocking the head cam action. I'm so proud of that. I don't need to put this on because there's a light in here, but it's just every time that idea, you know, ever since that idea came to me, every time I've just been like, oh yeah. This is a sharpening stone. You treat these with revere and respect and all that because they're quite fragile and brittle. They're not especially expensive. I don't know. I've never tried to buy one. I don't think they are. I mean, my dad's got like 6 or even 10. At least 5. I'm looking, there's a little squeegee bottle that he has his oil in. Let's see what we've got here. Some lovely mouthwash. Some schmoo. As the good man calls it. Some adhesive. We've got here Loctite, retaining compound. It's Loctite, that's what it is. And we've got blue Loctite, or Lock Prep, for locking Rovenpeitendugen, whatever the hell that says. I can't really speak German, in fact I can't even read it. It's gone off in 2009 anyway. Ah, dear, oil, I just need a bit of oil. Ah, aha! I knew there was one in a little squeezy bottle, and this is very good. You know, you do the, you're like, it's not working, this can's broken, it's defective, you know, what you gotta do. You gotta do that. Hold on. Now you have to undo the cap first. There you go. There's another one where you, it's got a tin thing and you boop it and it comes out. Anyway, we need a little bit more than that. There we go. Perfect. We need a bit of the most precious substance known to man. There we go. The most precious substance known to man. Lovely. Oh shit. And let us begin. Now, there's two ways you can do this. There's the wrong way, and there's the right way. What you want to do is you want to get a bit of oil on your knife. And you want to push it towards the stone. You see them a lot, especially in films, they drag it away. That's okay. This is better, doing it this way. There's not really a wrong or a right way, it's just your preference. I mean, you could drag it backwards like that. And just really, it's really more down to the type of steel you've got and the way that you were taught to do it originally and what way works for you. But there are a few disadvantages. Because if you do this wrong, you can blunt the face. But if you drag it backwards, you'll roll it over. You'll end up with a little rolled bit. And what I mean by that is because the steel, you know, it's not perfectly hard. It has a springiness, to it. So I'm struggling to speak because it's, you know, Sunday night and I've been using my cognitive functions all day. So we're kind of running on empty. But it has a ductile property to it if you want. That's its ability to be, you know, shaped and drawn out into a wire. And that leads to, if you sharpen it on one side, especially doing it backwards, you'll end up with just like a little raggedy burr on the side of the blade. That's why pushing it forward's better, because you're not pushing it over the edge, you're bringing it back toward, that material is coming back towards you. If that makes any sense? I don't know. Doesn't make any sense to me. And I'm the one who's trying to explain it. Christ. But anyway, you can see what I'm doing. You'll tell me that it's wrong. You'll be, you know, there'll be somebody out there who knows best. You know, the internet's full of people that know best. I like to mix it up. Give it a bit both ways. But according to my father, that's the way forward, not backwards. Which makes sense. But you know, everybody knows best. And that is getting quite sharp already. And you don't want to be too steep on this either, because you'll just scratch the stone. You want to be nice and shallow. You know, try and think about what you're doing. You're trying to wear the metal into a fine point, so it's like this. You don't want to do it like that. You want it like this. You know? That's effectively what you're doing when you're sharpening. You're taking away material. I haven't even worked out what I'm going to call this video. It's not really about anything. I mean, yeah, it's me doing my knife, but, you know, we've got all this Zen stuff going on here. How's that edge? Feels a lot better. Let's wipe the schmoo on it a bit more. Try it backwards a little bit. You want to try and do it the same way each time, as much as you can, like with your technique. I mean, if I was a serious knife person, and I'm not, I sound like it, but I'm really not. You know, I'm just a hobbyist. I just use my knife, I don't revere it. I do not serve my knife serves me, I suppose you could say. And that's the danger with any hobby. You know, you've got to remember, you know, a lot of people kind of lose sight of this, I think, when they try and enjoy themselves, is that, you know, and they wonder why their hobby's not very fun, or as fun as it might be, and they have to lie to themselves about it. You know, the hobby is there to serve you, in my mind. You're not there to serve it, you know. I enjoy things like my fine tools, my possessions, and my car, and all that sort of thing, but it serves me. I do not serve it. I am not put upon this earth to, you know, I do not put myself about this earth to maintain my car. You know, it's not the imperative, if you will. I am the imperative, and the car has to serve me and bring me enjoyment. And if it can't do that, I'll try and keep, you know, change that situation so it can. But you know, you got to keep bearing on this. Otherwise, you'll end up, you know, with a beaten up old car that you're about to spend £5,000 on to fix it. And you really have to ask yourself, what on earth is going on? You know, you have to step back and see the big picture. You want to kind of draw this out into a point as well, so you've got a nice sharp point. And I might just sharpen the point of the blade separate like that. But you've got to be careful of that, because you'll end up with a little trench in your stone, and you don't really want to do that, especially if this is someone else's stone and they don't know that you're using it. You see, we're getting a little bit dry. We're going to need a bit more lubricant soon. But, oh, look at that. Perfection. Almost. You see, it's happened. We've got burrs. I'm going to have to go forward on this now. It's just a little bit too soft to do backwards, but I can't do it forwards very well. I'm not very practiced. A harder steel, you might do it backwards. You know, not something like a samurai sword. Almost slipped. Another hazard of it doing this. Oily fingers and so forth. That's better. Much better. Much smoother. And what pitch and what angle you hold this at will define really how sharp your edge is and how long it will last, because you're changing this. You know, if you hold it more at an angle, this is going to be wider and it might not last as long. But you'll touch it up again really easy, where if it's, the edge is more like that, you know, obviously that will last longer and it will be sharper in general because the end is thinner. But then it will take longer to sharpen. And you want to kind of do it the same on both sides, so that this is in the middle and it's not like this or like this. You know, you want it straight, so when you're applying force, you know, you're getting 100% of that. It's not being deflected left or right as you're trying to cut something. Now, if I was a real pro knife person, another thing I would do is I'd have a little, you know, I'd have all these needle files for getting in here and sharpening these little nooks and crannies in here. You know, what for flaying somebody's guts when you run them through, as all us crazy knife-carrying maniacs often do. As well as, you know, stripping wire, cutting cardboard, cutting plasterboard, and all the stuff that we do during the day. You know, that's, you know, if you wanted to get serious, you would, and also you'd sharpen this both ways, because look, it's only sharpened one way, and you can see I'm beginning, just by virtue of what I'm doing with the blade, I'm beginning to sharpen these the other way. But you'd get a needle file and you'd go in there and you'd sharpen those up good and proper on the dish and on the point, or the trough and the wave, or however you want to say it. Depending on where you're from, there'll be troughs and waves, there'll be dishes and towers or points or whatever you call them. You know, it's just specialist vocabulary. It's the same thing. Doesn't, you know, just by you call it a different name. You know, it's like today on my exam, I got a question wrong. I got a question wrong, right? Because I had to name the expansion vessel, but I called it a pressure vessel instead of an expansion vessel, because it expands to take up the rise in pressure. It does not, you know, it's something like that they came up with, and I just thought, well, fuck me. You know, if I go into the merchants and ask for an expansion vessel, or if I go into the plumbing merchants and say ask for an expansion vessel, Guess what they're going to give me? They're going to give me the same exact thing every time. Anyway, everyone. Forget what I was talking about because I was rudely interrupted, but that is nice and sharp now. If we look closely, I know everything is going to focus, but you can see. Well, you can't really see because it's not a very good camera, but it's nice and sharp, and that'll do us for the week ahead. Time well spent, you know. Thank you for joining me this evening for this little chat, and this may be the shape of things to come, as I don't really have a lot of free time at my disposal at the moment. Can't be dealing with it. Well, I can. I want to do it, but, you know, you've got to make time for the things that, you know, you want to do. Like now. You know, you can leave the oil on it. I like to clean things after I use them. It's a sickness, I know. Yeah, this weird common courtesy illness I have of mine. But, yeah. That's just shaped up lovely. Beautiful. Yeah, thank you for watching, and ta-da. And good luck.